Hi, Henk Akmans here, Supply Chain Dynamics, Chapter 9, Quality Cascade. Clip number, Sysdea, clip number 7. Changes in quantity and quality in the order inflow. What I would like to show now is the differences in increase on the workload of the system as a result of the increase in the quantity of the order inflow and of the quality of the order inflow. I have to do this, I have to simplify the input a bit so that we can test it. First of all, I have to make the order inflow fixed. And I have a separate switch for that. I can turn that on so that I will have a fixed order flow here. There you go. I still have the service order inflow up here, so I can also turn that off. Ignore the service order percentage here, put it back to 0%. And now I have a nice inflow. It's really boring. The green lines you have to watch. You see that gradually there's a little increase there. If you look at the quantity of staff, also very modest increase. Not quite fixed, but almost fixed. And now let's give a step input here that we have an increase of, like, say, 20% new service orders, new orders, and see what that does to our system. And there you have that increase, 20% more, so on 4,000K, so some 800 more, I assume. Yeah, there we go. 800. And what that does then to the system. Now, it's interesting if you look at provisioning, for instance. 20% more staff and provisioning here. 20% more work does lead to a higher input. Just follow the green lines here. Increase in provisioning rework because there are some workload effects. That's really difficult to see from here. But we do have a peak and it's slightly bigger. If you then look at the FTE that we talk about, then we go from like 50 to over 60. So that is more or less a 20% increase. Slightly more because of some workload effect, but some 20% increase. What we could even do is put that 20% increase up here and copy it to up here, so we have some comparison graph in there. Now let's field install mostly the same. Agent pipeline, well, that's bigger, that's bigger. Fair enough. Now, suppose that I don't increase the volume, but I increase the quality. So I do not have an increase of new orders of 20%. I only have an increase of the quality step size. So I have a dip in quality of 20%. Now the income quality is 80. 80% of the orders are fine. But what if that incoming order quality has indeed this dip? What happens then? So there's no more new sales order coming in. But what you do get is that there is more work in rework. As you can see here, we have quite a substantial peak in rework, bigger than in the original system even. Technicians is not so big the difference. Why? Well, because provisioning, most of the provisioning, indeed all the capacity in provisioning, is around here in the fallout of the automated process. This is partly a non-automated process. And if you then look at the FTE in field install and in provisioning, we still have the original. The red line is what we had after 20% increase in volume. Now look at the green line and see how 20% decrease in quality actually leads to a more than doubling of the workforce in provisioning, whereas first we had a 20% increase. So no more volume of work, but far more work as a result of quality issues, which is then the real volume that we have here. FTE field install, less so, but of course still significant. Call handling, also quite substantial. But the main point we made is in this automated process of provisioning, where all the orders that flow through really cost no capacity. The cost of quality is really high. All the handling is more or less the cost of low quality.